Thank you very much. Chairman Ashby, my questions really have to do with one area in particular that's of importance to me and my constituents, and that's the pre-K funding. And I've heard a lot of things, and I want to just clarify with you and so the body can understand what we've actually done. So,
sure.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Last session, the governor made pre-K an emergency item. We passed House Bill 4. It created a grant program for high-quality pre-K outside of the formula. And I actually was the only Democrat, I believe, who voted against that because I didn't think it went far enough. I thought we should spend more, and I thought it should be done through the formula. What have we done to House Bill 4 in this budget, the pre-K grant program created by the governor?
So there is $236 million in the conference report for the high-quality pre-K program.
What does that mean exactly? There's $236 million. In the conference report.
So
how is it?
So for the school districts that qualify for the high quality pre-K program, House Bill 4, there's $236 million earmarked in this budget for that program.
So I'm wrong then, I guess, if it's my understanding that this money is not part of their foundation school program funds through the formula, as opposed to the grant program? Because it's my understanding that the grant program is gone in this new budget, and we're asking them to now run pre-K programs with their existing half-day funding that they've been receiving up to now. That's how they're supposed to meet these new higher quality standards with existing funds, as opposed to having access to a new pool of money. Is that correct?
So the $236 million for the high-quality pre-K, I think the chairman mentioned in his layout, is part of the overall funding for pre-K in the budget, which is $1.6 billion through the foundation school program. So that $236 million is encompassed or included in the $1.6 billion.
I've also been told, and I want to understand what this rider is that was included in the conference report, that it says, from what I have, that 15% of their money has to be spent on these high-quality programs. What is this rider telling our school districts they have to do that operate a pre-K program?
Representative Johnson, if you don't mind, I think I'm being handed a note here in regards to Representative Dutton's question. Let me check with the staff on the exact intent of that rider.
Okay,
and get back to you.
Because I'll tell you what my concern is and what I really am worried about. I'm worried about the fact that we've asked our school districts who were actually pretty excited about this grant program last session that I didn't even get excited about because I didn't think it was enough. I feel like we're asking them to do the same things we were asking them to do last session that the governor wanted them to do, but now we're not giving them the resources to do it with. Or asking them to do it with existing resources and to take money that would otherwise be theirs to use how they want to meet these higher standards, but we haven't given them any access to any additional funds to do it. So I would appreciate the clarity if you wouldn't mind.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.